So this is Sugar Dragon S8, one of Paul Thompson's seedlings. And this was crossed with Hooten and Rixford, the double red flesh varieties. Both were red flesh. So you can see it's created a beautiful olive skin. It will get a little bit yellow with a lot of sun and as it grows, but it's nothing to be concerned about. These things are really tough. It can be a little bit hard to root at times if they're mature cuttings, but they're really thick, really hardy. They're not too spiny. They get 1 to 3 of these smaller horn spines. It's not too bad compared to other varieties. And I've taken several cuttings from this plant as well. So you can see here's some newer growth. It'll be a little bit kind of yellow and green, but it will darken up quickly. It's topping the trellis here, doing great. So that's 8S Sugar Dragon. In my opinion, the most important one because it's a universal pollinator. All right, let me show you my other favorite seedling. All right, this is Paul Thompson's 9S or Dark Star. Now, I have not gotten fruit from this plant. It's about a year old. You can see it's just doing really well. Scott has a Dark Star at his house too. And we both would agree that we both observed that this is just a very vigorous grower. It started growing early in the season in about April. So believe it or not, all these cuttings are new this season already, especially this one. So huge, super red. This was last year. We observed it grow about 1 inch a day almost. So it's just such a really vigorous growing dragon fruit variety in my opinion. And what I really like about it is that it topped the trellis earlier this spring. This is all new growth from about, I'd say, April. And it's already shooting new growth off of that. It's gotten thick and it's ready to support more branches. So wow, Dark Star to me and Sugar Dragon are the two most vigorous growers in my experience so far. Let me go show you one more. And last but certainly not least, 3S Delight. So you can see it's a very vigorous grower. And I actually have two cuttings from two different sources. One is, believe it or not, directly from Paul Thompson. I found a dragon fruit grower who was friends with him, and I collected all but 4S. And then on the left here is a different source, Exotica Nursery, who also knew Paul Thompson. So you can see that this one was severely damaged. I just literally got a stick. It was like a trunk must have had a rot. And you can see it in 1 year, just how much Delight has grown. So that's all one cutting there on the left. It's doing really great. We'll get a little bit of bug damage there on Delight. See it there? But it thickens up quickly and is very, very vigorous as you can see. So this is topping the trellis and this cutting. All these cuttings are about a year old. So Delight Dragon Fruit. This was Paul Thompson's favorite. He named it. So I will always enjoy that and respect that. All right, and there you go. Give us a like and a subscribe. We'll talk more about Paul Thompson's book in the future. I have much to share. All right, take care.